Good morning, welcome back to the channel. Got a Model A starter here, we're going to talk about a little bit. But this is what engages into the, this is the BENDIX, what they call a starter BENDIX. And when you hit the starter, the centrifugal force forces this back into the ring gear, flywheel ring gear. And this spring, it actually takes some of the, I guess some of the shock out of it, per se, that so it don't hit the flywheel so violently. So you can see how it moves. And also on a Model A, sometimes these tabs will break, the bolts will come loose, and these bolts will actually fall down into the flywheel housing. And they'll lock the engine up, like when you turn it off to go back to start it, the engine will lock up. And most time you gotta put it in high gear and rock it back and forth until it comes undone. And the reason is the flywheel ring gear runs so close into the housing that this will actually get hung in the starter teeth, or the ring gear teeth, and when you go to start it, it'll hit in the flywheel housing and lock it up. And so you can, like I say, you can put it in reverse and or in high gear and rock it back and forth and get broke loose. And sometimes you have to pull the transmission out to get this bolt out. And but sometimes also it's worth a try to stick a pretty good magnet on the flywheel and roll the flywheel around and see if it'll pick the bolt up. But if you have it off and you're replacing the BENDIX, you need to make sure you got good tabs to bend over and they're locked good. And some people use these BENDIX with 12 volts, and when you do it with 12 volts, it really kicks that starter ring hard, and sometimes it'll try to drive the starter ring off of the flywheel, and it can't come plumb off because it'll actually hit a bolt in the where the flywheel housing bolts to the back of the block. But if I was running 12 volts on a starter, I would use this starter here, and this is like for an 8N Ford tractor. They're a little aggravating to put on. You have to pull this back, and it's pretty good little job to pull back. It's tight, and then you screw this set screw out. And then you slide it on the starter, and there's the Woodruff key slot, and then screw the set screw back in, and it can't come out because the washer's holding it. And But I like these pretty well if you're using a 12 volt setup. And I'm gonna show you how the BENDIX actually engages into the flywheel when it starts. So I've got a test motor. It's actually a motor I rebuilt, the last one I rebuilt. And so I thought to myself, well, I'll just make a video of the starter engaging and show you fellas how that works. So I'll get everything set up, and we'll show you how that BENDIX kicks in. You can see this is just floating here. It's got a heavy side that keeps it out of the way. But I'm gonna show you how it kicks in and how it kicks out. So I'm gonna push the starter. So you can see how it kicks in and out. Now we're going to start the engine up. You can see the flywheel ring gear helps throw it out too. here it is in slow-mo.